Today we are going to start Unit 13, Verbs, Be, Has, and Do. Children, verbs are of two kinds, helping verbs, that is also called the be or being verbs, and the main verbs. Let's see. Be verb gives information about the subject. They are called being verbs. Let's read the given sentences, children. I am a nurse. Here, am is a be verb. I am a doctor. In this sentence also, am is a be verb. Who is he? Here, is a be verb. They are birds. Here, are is a be verb. He is a clown. Here, is a be verb. Am is used with I and is used with singular nouns and pronouns. Children, we have already studied about singular and plural nouns and pronouns in previous chapter. Are is used with plural nouns and pronouns. Are is used with you in both singular and plural form. Children, we use be verb after the subject and before the main verb. Okay, let's start the exercises, children. Exercise 1. Fill in the blanks with am, is, or are. Number 1. I am a student of class 2. Number 2. We are playing football. Number 3. My father is a pilot. Number 4. You are a very naughty boy. Number 5. It is raining outside. Completed. Now come to the exercise 2, children. Tick write the right word. Children, in this exercise, we have to take the correct helping verb given in the brackets. I am giving you only the correct answer. Arushi is my sister. Anil and his friends are playing cricket. The windows are broken. Those are the new books. I am studying in this school. My sister Anita is sleeping in her room. I am 10 years old. Only one book is on the table. We are not very late. Number 10. They are in the park. Completed. Now come to the exercise 3, children. Complete the sentences by looking at the pictures. One is done for you. Number 1. There are 2 trees. Number 2. These are cherries. Number 3. There are 2 cars. Number 4. This is an apple. Number 5. There are flowers in the garden. Completed, children? Children, let's learn about has and have. Children, has and have are the helping verb of present perfect tense. But has and have we use for showing possession. Let's read some sentences. I have a bike. We have new bikes. You have a bike. They have new bikes. Raman has a bike. He has a bike. Sita has a bike. She has a bike. Children, have we use with plural number noun and pronoun, and have also used with I and you pronoun. Has we use with the singular number noun and pronoun. Has and have are verbs that tell us what people have or possess. They are called having verbs also. Has is used with singular nouns or pronouns. One person or thing. He, she, Sita, Raman. These all are in singular form. Have is used with pronouns I and you and plural nouns and pronouns. More than one. I, you, we, they, boys, girls. Okay, let's see the exercises. Look at the picture, then complete the sentences. Number one. Look, the monkey has a long tail. Here, monkey is in singular form. Number two. Jugal has a new dictionary. Here, the subject Jugal is singular noun. Number three, they have got their report cards. Here, they is a plural pronoun. Number four, this house has many windows. Here, the subject is in singular number. Number five, the two birds have very strong beaks. Here, the subject is in plural form. Number six, I have a baby sister. Here, I is a first person singular number pronoun. Number seven, you have a very pretty frock. Children, we use have with you also. Completed. Number 8. She has fever. Here, she is singular number pronoun. Number 9. He has many wonderful stamps. Here, he is singular number pronoun. Number 10. We have tickets. Can we go in? Here, we is plural number pronoun. Completed. Now come to the exercise 5. Read and then match the following. One is turn for you. Children, 3 columns are given. In first column, noun or pronoun are given. In second column, verb has or have are given. And in third column, sentences are given. We have to match these 3 columns and make proper or correct sentences. Number 1 has been done for you. I have decided to study hard. Number 2. Rashid, John and Jaswinder have gone to school. Number 3. She has bought a new watch. Number 4. Roshan has a new pet dog. Number 5. Kamla has to go out and play. Number 6. You have bought a new dress. Number 7. The children have a new storybook to read. Completed. Children, let's learn about do and does. Do and does are the helping verbs of present tense. We use do with plural nouns and pronouns, and we use does with the singular nouns and pronouns. See, we use do with plural nouns and the pronouns. I, you, we, and they. Let's read the given sentences. I do my homework every day. You do your homework every day. We do our homework every day. They do their homework every day. The boys do their homework every day. Okay. Let's read some more sentences given. We use does with singular nouns and the pronouns. And it. See, Seema does her homework every day. Roshan does his homework every day. She does her homework every day. He does his homework every day. The maid does her work every day. I hope you have understood, children. Let's solve the exercises. Exercise 6. Fill in the blanks with do or does. In my home, we do the housework together. Father does the shopping and mother does the cooking. Children, here we is plural pronoun. Father and mother are the singular noun. My sister does the washing of dishes and I do the drying of dishes. My sister and I do the dusting of the house together. Completed. Now come to the exercise 7. Complete the sentences with do or does. Number 1. I always do my homework myself. Number 2. My mother does the washing. Number 3. Teacher, what does the word comprehension mean? Number 4. Raju does not look happy today. Do you like my new kitten, Rani? Completed? Children, here we completed Unit 13. You have to complete your grammar book. That's all for today's tutorial. Thank you. Take care. Bye.